How did we end up here? I could have been reviewing Halo Infinite's multiplayer, moaning about the skins and cosmetics, or maybe talk about how the single player doesn't achieve the Halo 3 heights. And yet I'm sitting here, naked, reviewing retired men's nude beach volleyball league. My own community thinks it's a bad idea, yet here I am, and so are you. And there are only two reasons for why you're here. You either saw the trailer and were amazed by it and intrigued, or you just randomly stumbled upon my video, in which case, hey, I'm sorry. I would like to start by showing it to you again because it's a dope-ass trailer, first of all. And second of all, I think it provides meaningful context for what we're about to do. So let me just put on my shirt while you watch Retirement's Nude Beach Volleyball League trailer. Here we go.
You gotta play with your heart. Give it all that you got. Take a shot, serve it up on the ball with everything you got. Stand in the sand. You're a retired man. Yeah, this is life. Here you are, back and forth. This is your.
Okay, now I think one thing that we can all agree on is that this trailer is intriguing. And that's why I decided to give this game a shot in the first place. And wow, what an experience. Now, this is one of the very few examples of a game that cannot be reviewed properly without spoiling pretty much the entire thing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to talk about the very superficial aspects of this game, and then we're going to delve into the spoiler territory, and I'm going to mark it somehow on this video. It'll all be clear. So Retired Men's Nude Beach Volleyball League is an extremely heartfelt, well-written, vulnerable narrative experience backed up with quite frankly, broken gameplay. Now, there's a very good reason for why the gameplay is broken, but that actually goes into the spoiler territory, and we'll have to get to that later. You essentially play as Len. He is a retired man who joins a nude volleyball league. The game spans across 5 weeks, and during each week, you face another challenger. So you essentially play 5 volleyball games. You drive to each one of them, and during the ride, Len kind of reflects on his life, his regrets. There's so many fragmented thoughts, and it's up to you to kind of put them together and make up a whole narrative out of them, which I really liked. And where this game shines in that aspect is that these memories, they're not one-dimensional, right? They're not only these like dark regrets, because this is the idea that you would have by watching the trailer, or kind of just like thinking about it, is, oh, well, it's an old man who kind of reflects on his life and thinks like, oh, there's so many things I could have done better, which obviously they are, but it's also filled with so many beautiful memories that the character revisits from, you know, places he worked at, people he met and dated, and friends he had made. And all of this is delivered to you on the rides in the car, as I mentioned before, and during the volleyball games where you face the opponents. The characters have this back and forth, and they're very memorable. By learning about them, you kind of also learn about Len, and it goes back and forth. You know the deal. Okay, you know the deal. It's a narrative indie game. That's how it all works. Now, for the first match, I was extremely frustrated because first of all, I started playing this with a mouse and keyboard. Well, actually, just the keyboard. That's all you ever use. And that felt terrible. So I thought, hey, you know what? I might try the controller. Try the controller. It felt just as bad. I think I've lost almost every single match. That's how bad I was. Now, I'm usually bad at games, but this is a very special case because it's styled as this like old 16-bit kind of game, and the collision detection is so weird, and the depth of field, you never know where the ball is gonna hit, so it's a mess. It's such a mess. Oh my god, this game is such a mess, to the point where the last match that I played, I just gave up and I kept losing intentionally just to drive the story forward because I kind of wanted to get over with it. And this is not just my opinion. I'm 99.9% sure you're gonna have a very similar experience, and yet I think you absolutely should play this game. Why? This is where we go into the spoiler territory. So if you want to buy this game, if you want to play it, don't watch this video any further. Come back to it later, hopefully, because, you know, I'm going to go through an analysis. But if you're not planning on playing this game, I'm just going to lay it all out for you. And honestly, I think you're going to regret this. So think about it again, because once I'll say it, there's no turning back. So there's a hidden Easter egg in the game where should you exit through the game's menu, you are presented with a fake OS, like a fake computer screen. We've seen that in Super Hot and a bunch of other games. And there are lots of files laying around on the desktop, which you can interact with. Some of them have just photos. Others have music tracks, like recordings of somebody playing an acoustic guitar. There are some notes about the game itself. There are notes about the potential names for this game, to-do lists of like bugs to fix it and stuff like that. And that immediately caught my attention, but I thought it's a kind of like indie developer Easter egg, right? This is the developer's desktop. Well, no, because by the end of the game, it turns out that this desktop belongs to Len. He's an old retired man who decided to make a game about his previous experiences, and he decided to make it into a retired old man's nude volleyball game. You come across this computer as his granddaughter. It's somewhere in the attic, and you start going through the files, and in fact you playing the game as the player is actually the character of his granddaughter playing that game on the computer. And she apparently studies game design or something, so she comes to the same conclusions as the player. I think somewhere in her dialogue she even mentions, well, the collision detection is kind of off. And this is where suddenly this game that was frustrating you through the entire playthrough takes on this whole new meaning, where you're playing a game that is made by an old man who just started to learn programming or whatever, and this is his first kind of game. It's his first project. All of a sudden, it became just so much more sincere. It almost makes you want to go back, as frustrating as that gameplay is, to kind of replay those things, because now you have this like completely different context. And so all the monologues that Len goes through are actually his own. And every character that he meets and plays against are actually characters from his life. And the conversations that he has with them are the conversations that he perhaps wanted to have with them in his life. So there's so much careful writing that went into this game to make it feel both very emotional, but not to the point where it's self-indulgent or maybe a bit too dark, or, you know, just hammering down this one note of emotions. And so if you're watching this video and you haven't played the game, or you're not even planning to, I honestly feel bad, because I feel like I've robbed you of this experience. But I've been literally sitting on this game for a couple of days now, wondering if I should even review it in the first place. And although I have a very small community, I think this is the least that I can do to kind of shine more light on experiences like these, because they're very special and they deserve their own place and their own spotlight in the games industry. And I hope that, as good as this trailer is, that it doesn't outshine the game. I really like this game. I can't recommend it enough. And if you think I'm being too easy on this game, check my 12 minutes review.